Greetings everyone, my name is Rima and as an Acumatica developer, I'm excited to guide you through the process of creating, filtering and grouping reports. Additionally, we will discuss how to save and publish these reports on your Acumatica site. I hope you find this information helpful and informative. Then let's get started. Let's start by creating a report using the sections that we are familiar with from our first video. For this report, let's assume that we need to list all the invoices with a balance greater than, let's say, $500, and display their invoice number, invoice amount, and customer name. To gather more information, we need to view the invoices screen to know all about the fields that we need. So we are already on the invoices screen. And by using the inspect element, we can identify the table and field names. Now we can find it here, inspect element, and we'll click on the field that we want to know about the details. For example, we need the reference number of the invoice, and by clicking on that, we see that its data class is our invoice and the field name is ref number. So we can copy them and go to our report designer. So as we remember, first of all, we need to add our table here. And after that, we'll be able to add the fields. So we have filled our URL and login with password. And also don't forget to add your tenant name if you have. So we'll find here our IR invoice. That's it. Clicking on them and moving to our site. And it's the only doc that we need for now. And now we'll go to add our fields here. The column names will be created in the page header sections here, as they will be shown on each page. And as we should show a list of invoices with their customers, we'll show them in the details section. So for adding our column names, so we'll use text boxes. First column will be the customer. For not dragging text box every time, we can copy it and paste it to have two columns, and we'll just edit the name. The second one will be invoice number. And the amount. Now in the details section, we'll add our fields. We can copy it and edit the value here. Now we'll look for the customer name here. We need this one. And we'll validate it to know that everything is correct. Okay, and creating the next one. It should be the invoice number, as we remember. We'll need to check the name. We need text one. particularly or each document. We can just copy it and replace the graph number with query or each document. Everything is correct. Now we can already try to preview it. Here are some random data, and we can make the column names bold. And this one. Also, we can add a line to separate them from the fields. And we say that's more beautiful. Now, how we can filter them to see only the invoices that have more than $500. We should add it in the filters because we are filtering our data. We should find the data we need. It's the query or each document. That's it. Condition is creator, then 500, apply, and OK. Here are all the amounts that are greater than 500. Also, what we can do if we want to see not the not all of the invoices altogether, but want to see grouped by some customers. Let's say here we have some customers repeating, and we want to see a grouped version. We should add a grouping here, checking here that it should be report one report, and going to the data part in the groups section. We have already filters because the collection is already bolted as we have added, and we need to add a grouping here, and it will be added here. Add data field. It should be customer ID. And we'll define a name for the grouping. Okay, that's it. Here we see that there is added group header section and group footer section that we are familiar with from our previous video. And of course that we need to show only the customer names and not to be repeated. For example, here we can see repeated, but we don't want to see repeated. We want only a header here with the name of the customer, and after that the invoice numbers and amount, and after that again customer name, invoice numbers and amounts for each of them. Then we need to move the field in the group header section, and we can delete it from here, and we can see also we can make it with another style font. It can be maybe italic preview. That's it. Now, how we can save it to our Acumatica site and publish it there. Now, save to server, adding the credentials, loading reports list, and giving the name. For example, copy it. it's already saved to our system. Now how we can publish it to check every time our report and run it. We hit go to sitemap. And add a row for this report. But before adding the row, we should copy a URL example for some reports. Report launcher. It will be modified for our report. The name was white. Well, test always record the URL, and it should be changed. And of course, we'll add a workspace. It can be, for example, receivables. And here, of course, reports. And we'll just save it. Now, in our receivables part, we should see it in the reports. Show all. In the report section, test invoice report, and in the URL section, of course, you should see the screen ID as your report name, YT26 and zeros. Now we'll run, and it's opened. We can see here. Go on the last page. We can see the grouped parts in every page. That's it for filtering and grouping our reports. Also, if you have any questions about this part, please leave them in the comment section. And if you need our help of creating a report, please contact our team. We are always happy to help you. Thank you for watching. See you in our next videos. Thank you. Bye.